Hello and good morning, friends. Today, I want to talk to you about leaking septic tanks, right? So what is it? Why is it a problem? And what do you do when that happens? So let's get into this. A septic tank is going to be what kind of catches all the solids from your toilet, right? Sink, shower, all that good stuff. It's just a big concrete box. Anytime you flush a toilet, all that debris goes into the tank. And the goal of the tank is to separate those solids so that way you can clear up the effluent before it works its way into the absorption system. Now, a septic tank is supposed to be watertight. And the purpose of that is you're not supposed to have sewage leaking out in that particular area. It's supposed to go to the absorption system. Sometimes in some counties, those tanks would be pretty close to the well because they were watertight. Now, in our area, your area might be a little bit different. Some of these tanks would be made with the mid-seam, right? And a mid-seam tank is basically where you would have half the tank, the other half, and then you would put it together with some kind of mastic or sealant. Now, that is usually the part that ends up breaking. And how you can tell very quickly is when you look inside of the tank, you'll see that the water level is at about halfway mark, right? So for this particular system, we're going to be looking through the clean out, and in a second, I'm going to show you inside of the tank. So the first thing you want to know when you're looking at a tank and whether or not it's leaking is when was the last time it was pumped, right? If it was pumped a couple days ago or a week ago and the house is occupied, it probably could make sense that the water level's not quite up to where it belongs. If the house is vacant, it's a little bit more tricky to do that, right? And so what I mean by this is if the house is occupied, you pump it down through the normal course of showering, dishes, toilets, etc., it's going to fill back up. Generally, a family of four, from the time you pump out the tank before it's full, anywhere from a week to maybe 2 weeks for them to fill it back up, right? So if they pumped it recently, that can give you kind of a false representation of whether or not the tank's leaking. So first thing is, when was it pumped? The next thing is, what's the occupancy, right? If it's been vacant for a while, you could make an argument that maybe it leaked a little bit, but generally, it's not gonna be that much of an argument, right? Most of the tanks, if it's leaking, it's gonna be leaking enough to where it's gonna be a problem. So what can happen with a leaking tank? Well, so I already discussed that if you have a tank that's close to a well, you could potentially be having sewage getting into your drinking water. The other thing you have to worry about is cavitation around the tank, right? It's not designed to dissipate that water. So if you have a lot of water going through, let's just say you have a quarter size hole in the tank, well, that quarter size hole will have a good amount of water flowing through it regularly, and then that'll wash away a lot of the soil, which can create a huge sinkhole in your yard, potentially hurting somebody. Not a good thing, right? So the way to deal with it, right? There's two ways, right? First way is to patch it, and the second way is to replace it. Now, patching, what is that? Basically, what they would do is they would clean out the inside of the tank and then dig up the outside of the tank, and then you would take hydraulic cement and you would mush it on the seal. Does that always work? Sometimes yes, sometimes no. I've not met a single installer who is willing to warranty that kind of repair, right? And in my opinion, if you're not willing to warranty your work, it's not worth getting that work done, right? Because the warranty basically says how confident you are as an installer that whatever you did is going to last. So generally, if you have a leaking tank, my recommendation is to consider a replacement of the tank because the cost is not that much more expensive and you know it's gonna last, right? You know it's gonna work well. You don't have to worry about in a year being right back where you started, having already shelled out $3,000 to patch it and then doing it again next year, right? So with the tanks, right, generally you're gonna see that a lot of these systems nowadays are going to be two chamber systems, right? They're going to have risers at grade, so it's going to have a little bit more of an aesthetic eyesore, but it's really not that bad, right? Let's go ahead, take a look inside of the tank and see kind of what we're working with. If you've been through a leaking tank before, let me know below. Tell me, have you ever had to have one replaced? Have you ever had an inspection where somebody came back and told you that the tank was leaking? Leave a comment below, share your story, but let's go ahead, take a look inside this tank. All right, so we've got our tank here, right? So this is going to be our cast iron clean out just below the surface. And then if we look inside of the tank, we can see that the water level is below the front baffle, right? So with the water level being below the front baffle, that's going to basically tell us that the water level is not at the outlet. When we stick our sludge judge in there, which is our measuring device, we can see that there's supposed to be about 4.5 feet of water. and there's only a little over 2 feet of water in the tank, meaning we're at about the halfway point. Now, when we're looking inside of this tank, remember, we want to see when was it pumped last. Homeowner has no idea when they pumped it. However, we can see that there's about 12 inches of sludge inside of this tank. So that means that it's been quite a while since somebody's pumped it. So we've got a low liquid level, a lot of sludge, and on top of that, we can see groundwater is infiltrating into the tank. That continuous flow of water is not from the home. That's going to be coming from the seal around the inlet pipe, and basically it's just got a bunch of groundwater floating into the tank itself. Now, this is going to be enough to where we can say this tank is obviously leaking and needs to be addressed. If you don't see water running, sometimes what you end up having to do is fill the tank back up to the correct level, measure it, come back after a day or two of not running water, and that'll kind of give you an idea of what it's doing. Leaking tanks aren't super common, but they do happen from time to time, right? If you ever come across a leaking tank, don't panic, but it is going to be an expense that you're going to make sure you get addressed. In the normal course of home ownership, right, as long as it's not backing up and as long as you're not getting it inspected, nobody's going to really pay that much attention to it. Is it going to cause that many issues? Probably not, but still shouldn't have it leaking. It's not designed to leak, right? So you got to make sure you take care of it when it starts leaking. I hope you found this useful. I hope you found this informative. If you enjoy content like this, I have more videos posted every day in the world of well and septic. Hit that like button and subscribe. Leave a comment below if there's an area of conversation you'd like me to cover. I look forward to talking to you guys soon. Till next time.